Mamma
Mia has been playing in Johannesburg at Monte Cassino, and I tell you what, we went to see it. It has been brilliant. Loads of people have been to see it, and we thought we'd invite some of the cast here. We've got Emmanuel Castis, who plays Sam Carmichael, and Kiruna-Lind, Devar, who plays Sophie, and we thought we'd invite them in before the show finishes, which is this coming Sunday, just to talk about, well, how it's been. When you were asked to do the show, I mean, both of you actually, I mean, Kiruna as well, I mean, when you were asked to do the show, obviously you'd seen the film, right?
Yeah, seen the live show as well, yeah.
Seen the live show as well. It must have been an honor. I mean, was it something you jumped at originally?
Oh, absolutely. It's an iconic show. I mean, the world has seen, I think 65 million people have seen this show globally.
Jeez.
Wow. Brilliant.
It's the power of the music. I mean, the ABBA repertoire is extraordinary. And you do it so well. I have to say, Kiruna, and I mean this in the best way possible, you are larger than life on stage. And you're actually teeny tiny in real life. Look at the size of you. And what a voice. How's the show been for you?
A real dream come true for me. You know, kind of playing my first big principal in South Africa in a book musical.
Yes.
And to be working with the people that I'm working with, and also that are so incredibly generous with their knowledge, their wisdom, their hearts, their talent. Sophie's been an amazing adventure for me. And in this voice that I found in her, like this singing all these big songs,
yes.
I found a big voice in my life, and it's been so liberating.
Now, it's not your, I mean, you get all sorts coming to, because I mean, like, some of the guys go, nah, this is not for me. I like watching rugby. I'm not going to go and watch Mamma Mia. But I mean, like, everyone goes and everyone gets involved, right?
Absolutely. Yes. Absolutely. And you can see, sometimes you can see when the husband has been dragged along and he's sitting there next to the wife, like, all sort of, you know. But eventually he can't help himself and stand up and boogie to the music.
And I mean, you say boogie to the music, but there are moments. And I mean, Kiruna, you'll know the one moment I'm talking about. There's a very, very touching moment between daughter and mum.
Yes.
Okay. Just before the big wedding.
Yes.
Which we all know how that turns up, but we won't actually reveal that on air for people that have maybe still to see the show. But I mean, there's a very, I mean, I got teary.
Yeah, I think that moment of slipping through my fingers is such a glimpse into the intimacy of mother-daughter relationships.
Yes.
Especially, you know, single mothers, and you know how beautiful it is to watch your child go through all of these things, but also as an adult looking at your mother experiencing life as well. And I think that's why slipping is such a tender moment in the show, where everything kind of comes down to the heart of what the show is about, which is love and care and the tenderness between Donna and Sophie.
Yeah,
that's such a beautiful moment.
And as you say, there's a lot of those moments in real life between mother and daughters happening every day. So you can equate to it.
Yes, 100%.
But I imagine that, I know you're talking about your own experience and perhaps your own mother, but I imagine Gina Schmuckler, who plays your mother, who's incredible.
Oh, yeah.
And I've worked with her as well in other scenarios. So it's been extraordinary to see her on stage, where she belongs. But I imagine that creating that tenderness, that connection on stage means that you guys must be like super besties off stage.
Gina has really touched my life. And obviously I've seen her on stage, I've seen her around, and I think there's a huge amount of mutual respect in the space.
Yeah.
But also for my mom, because my mom and Gina know each other well enough. My mother's also an actress, and so there was like an unspoken connection before we'd even begun.
Right.
But also because Gina is so, the word is generous. She gatekeeps nothing, not an emotion, not an ounce of knowledge. She's just so giving that it's so easy just to go, here's my heart.
Ah, oh, fabulous. Yes. And we get it. We get it as an audience.
And Emmanuel, I mean, as playing, I mean, you're there with the three dads. Are the dads mates? I mean...
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Great guys. Amazing guys. Yeah, just like... I actually bumped into Matt Newman the first time on a film set.
Yeah.
And Tian is just, I mean, he's a force to be reckoned with. This man is incredible on stage. He's just, and just such awesome guys. And, you know, because of the structure of the script as well, because of the show, how it is, we just naturally fell together and became these buddies.
Yeah.
Because it's like the dads are kind of the side story, you know, and just awesome. Yeah. First, we also have to say thank you to the audiences, you know. You know, post-COVID and everything, it's very rare to have such full theatres in South Africa. So it's been incredible. And thank you to you guys, HOT 102.7, for the support. It's just been incredible.
Thank you.
Well, I'm really glad. I'm glad it's been sold out. It's a lovely position to be in. And we look forward to... I know you played in the Jersey Boys some time back. What's next? Do we know... Have we got anything on the cards?
We are taking it as it comes.
Yep, yep. Right. Taking it as it comes, yeah.
Tis the theatre way.
The definition of a successful actor and actress is a working actor and actress.
Exactly.
On the stage. Thank you very much for coming in.